still 15, thank you, 15 I am indeed. Going at 15. What number, sir? What, 665, ladies and gentlemen, a papier mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached a picture of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item, discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here. Signor Ubaldo Bianchi, an honor, signor.
Yes, if I remember rightly, in
fine aria in Act 3 of the novel. I wonder, Signora, if, as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, Monsieur Reyes objects.
My manager commands, Mr. Reyes.
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient.
No.
Well taught.
Very well.
aria, then.
Where in the world have you been hiding? dear. Are you a dancer? Then come and practice. My dear, I was asked to give you this.
To describe it.
What a relief! Not a single refund!
Greedy!
Richard, I think we've made quite a discovery in Miss Dyer.
Ah, here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Yes. Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, Monsieur.
Thank you.
Well, they appear to have met before.
Christine Dyer, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. Not after all the trouble I took. I was just 14. Soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Ralph, so it is you.
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too?
Little Lottie. What am I fonder of dolls, or of carvings,
or
shoes,
or of riddles, of frogs?
Those pigments in the apple, or of chocolates?
Playing the violin.
We read to each other dark stories of the north. Of that, but now we go to supper.
No! No, the angel of music is very strict.
I shan't keep you up late.
I'm sorry,
you must change. Explain. I must get my hat. 2 minutes. Little Lottie.
Thank you. To see, to find a man behind the
monstrous, repulsive goddess who seems a beast, but secretly dreams of beauty.
Christine, I will be singing on your behalf tonight.
fortune should you attempt to take her.
Too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Dyer's name.
Miss Dyer has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I've asked that she at all.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will sing no one.
Will she sing? Oh, will she sing?
Oh, here, I have a note.
Let me see it.
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Dyer has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of In Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the paint boy, and put Miss Dyer in the role of Countess. Which Miss Dyer plays calls for charm and the role of the paint boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored,
a disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Christine! What an
Never can you hear.
I shall be sitting in box five.
Little do you mean box five? Certainly, my dear uncle. There appear to be no seats available other than box five.
Bring the ballet forward.
The ballet!
returned.
Human's eyes would have frightened me there.
You shouldn't say that.
Those eyes that burn and make me hands to kill a thousand men.
This way, the night.
The phantom of the opera.
The phantom of the opera.
My God, who is?
My God, who is this man?
Who is
lost? Love one.
Parliament.
So take me and love.
splendid party. Not for not to a bright new year. Every night I'm impressed when one does one's best. Here's to us, the toast of all the city. What a pity it's so bad to come here.
so silent, good monsieur? Did you think that I had left you for good? Have you missed me, good monsieur? I have written you an answer. Here I bring the finished score. Triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Greetings to
ought to act. Not her normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Pyongyi's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Dyer, no doubt she'll do her best. It's true, her voice is good. She knows for sure she wished to. She has much still to learn. If God will let her return to me, her teacher, her teacher, your obedient friend.
An angel.
And yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend. With this thing alone, we shall play his game, perform his work, and remember we believes. If Miss Dye sings, he is certain to attend. We make certain the doors are locked.
We make certain our arms are out.
We make certain they are
locked. The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Weakness!
I'm not so sure.
Now maybe worse.
Just weakness!
The tide will turn.
What do you mean? There is no way of turning the tide.
You stick the ballet. Then help us.
I shall not come.
Instead of warning us, help us.
I shall not come.
Don't make excuses. What could it be that you're on his side?
She's his uncle, this.
Sure, believe me, I intend no ill. But be sure to be careful. We have seen
we him. We can't afford it. So, it is to be war between us!
that way in the presence of the composer.
The composer is not here. And if...
Can you be certain of that, Signora?
So, once again, half a second.
my fathering gates against he returns.
Mind beats against
you. Jesus, get your soul.
Let me on in sin. Of no return, no backward glances, our games of make-believe are at an end. Past all thoughts of if or when, no use resisting, abandon thought and let the dream descend. What raging fire shall flood the soul? What rich desire unlocks its door? What sweet seduction lies before us? Past the point of no return, the final threshold, what warm unspoken secrets will we learn beyond the point of no return?
To that moment where speech is a thing. This pace which earned a mother's fear and loathing, a mask, my first unfeeling scrap of clothing. Pity comes too late, turn around and face your fate, an eternity abyss before your eyes. We have a guest, Christine! No! Sir, this is indeed an unparalleled delight. I had rather hoped that you would come. And now, my wish comes true. You have truly made my night.
Free her! Do what you like, only free her! Have you no pity?
Your lover makes a passionate plea.
It's useless.
I love her! Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion.
The world shall know compassion to me.
Christine, Christine, let me see her.
Be my guest, sir. Monsieur, I bid you welcome. Did you think that I would harm her? Why should I make her pay for the sins which are yours?
Show me you, you, my love.
secret you know of the angel in